Hi everybody, this is Patty, and I'm here today with a project for Crafty City for guest design team, and I had shared this paper that Archana sent me. It's called Sweet Secrets, and it's from Lemon Craft. It is comes from Poland. Now, I'll tell you, this is basically, I don't have a whole lot left. If you're going to do an album like this, I use the 12 by 12 basic paper pad. That was 12 double-sided papers. I used the collection kit, which was 6 double-sided papers. And then I used the smaller A7, I think it is, size, like 8.5 by 11 size. I use most of that. So that'll give you an idea of how much paper is in this. This is an 8 inch by 10 inch with a 4 inch spine mini. And it's got graduated pages, and I'll show you what I mean by that in just a moment. The spine, like I said, is 4 inches because I wanted it to lay pretty flat when I had it opened. Now, I wanted you to see here, on the outside of the paper pads was printed this gorgeous border that had looked like lacing in it. Well, I knew right away I was going to have to do something with that. So my sister-in-law had brought me this really pretty ribbon thread. I didn't leave any out here to show you. But I poked holes in all the printed lacing, and then I ran my own lacing through it. And I want to hold that up there so you can see the texture there. And then I just tied some of the ribbon, had a little piece of lace with a bling and a few charms on there. The back is plain. I did put corner mounts on the corners to protect it a little bit more. And then the only thing I've done on the front cover was I used this wonderful lace that my friend Cheryl Wells had sent me. In fact, most of the lace in here came from her. And I had these three pieces left, and I thought, well, why don't I just make a little photo presentation on the outside of the book. So that's what I have. I have two areas. I think these will hold 4.25 inch square photos in here. And then I've just put some flatback pearls around the outside. And I've never done one that had the photo mounted on the outside. And I'm going to just leave it as this. I'm not going to put any more adornment on it because I like it just like this. Okay, let's open it up so you can see what we have here. Okay, we have on the inside front cover, I have cut a circle die, and I have the template for this to show you what size to cut the photo to go in here in the back that I'm including. I have some butterflies that I've cut from the paper. These are the corner mounts for the corners. And now the first page, this graduates. Each page increases by an inch. So we have 4 inches, 5 inches, 6 inches, 7 inches, 8 inches, 9 inches, and then the book is 10. So you get this gradual effect as it goes through. On the first page, this opens like this and like this. It flips out. And then we have three pockets here. This is a tag from the paper line. Oh, I want to leave that out too because I haven't inked that. And here's one that I've made. Isn't this gorgeous paper? Oh my goodness. Really pretty paper. I will tell you, it's not as forgiving as some papers. I had trouble scoring and folding it. It wanted to crack a little bit. So my suggestion, if you're going to do much scoring or folding with this, is lightly mist your paper. Wait a few minutes. Let that paper soften just a little, but be very careful because places where I had ink that I rubbed, you can rub and tear a hole in the paper. So you just want to be cognizant of that, so you're a little bit more careful. Now this is the packaging material. See how shiny it is? But my goodness, I wasn't going to turn that down. That's just gorgeous. And this here leaves a place here to put a photo or journaling front and back. Okay, so that's this way. Now we flip it this way and we have 1, 2, 3, 4 more sections. Because what I've done on several of my pages, this is my hinge. Normally, what attaches to your hinge would be glued and glued on either two or three sides, depending on whether you wanted a pocket. I didn't do that. I only glued it across the bottom and left this part open. So that gives you two more surfaces that normally would be closed like this. I've never done it this way before, but I thought, why not? Why can't you do it that way? So now you just simply fold it back up. And in order to keep this one closed, I just have this pretty pink ribbon that my niece had given me that was in my stash. Now we open it. Now, this is some more of that lace that I was gifted, and I absolutely love it. But to put lace down, it's kind of hard because it wants to flop, you know, except where it's actually glued down. So I attached it. I don't know if we can see this or not. Let me get this here. I don't know. Can you see at all? What do I have? Oh, maybe the back of this. There. I attached it to a piece of clear acetate. And then I cut around the acetate similar to what the design of the lace is. You don't see that. You don't notice it. But it gives you now a really, really sturdy pocket for whatever you want to put in there. And then here's a little booklet I made that'll hold two photos, one on the back, and it has a pretty fussy cut piece that I cut out that slips there, and it just slips in here. Now we flip it, and we come to this page, and I have Happy that I've cut out on my Gemini, and I've cut it several layers, and then I cut it out of the paper, so it's pink, and then I put glossy accents over it, and I don't know if I can... There, maybe there you can see how it raises up. This is another one of the beautiful gifted laces that I cut apart. Now this pops up and this comes out. So you have a huge mat here, a mat here in the back. This pulls out so you can put a photo on it. And then when you're ready, you can tuck it in. Now I want you to see here, this is actually, and I don't know whether, I think it's this one. This is actually cut from the fly sheet of the paper, like this would be. I utilized everything. You can see I cut the flowers apart. Everything that was here, I utilized and cut it up. That's not, this is, I guess it's this one right here. But that's, so look at your paper. Use everything. This is gorgeous. You don't want to be thrown away just because it's the outside cover. So we slide that down, and then we have a mat here that goes in for a photo. Now the next page, I have one of these beautiful lace pieces here for like a corner pocket, and I have this clothespin. I think my friend Paula gave me this, but I'm not sure. And I put one of the little pop-up. It's kind of like a flat button. It doesn't have any button on the back, just foam. But I put that on, and this is going to be what holds this page closed. Now, I had this butterfly. I think this is a Webster's Pages butterfly, but it's eons old. But it was perfect for this book. Again, I have two photo mats, room on the back, and then I had this, just this little cut apart that I added and slipped over the top because it was so pretty. I just didn't want to waste it. Now, again, here on this one, I've done the same as I did on that other page. I only glued it to the hinge portion, and I left it open so that I had all this other paper to work with. I have two belly bands here that I have fussy cut the flowers out, and they have a bookmark, both of them, that slides down, and it slides down in amongst the flowers. You'll see here some of it's glued behind, some of it's left free, so that the bookmark will slide between it. And then on both sides, I have this neat, holds really big photos, and a big one on the back and the front. I didn't put anything on the front, so a photo could be put there by whomever purchases this one. This one will be for sale. And then there's this one, which is identical. The butterflies may be a little bit different, and it slides underneath. But by only gluing to your hinge, you are doubling the space of what you have. Now, before I put my clothespin back on, I have this one that I made for this side, and I left it free. and I just have a different corner rounder up there. But see now, when I put my clothespin on both sides, over the top here, it will hold it here, and pardon me, it will hold, excuse me, it will hold it here as well, just so it's not flying out of the book when you open it. Now on this one, this is another one of the laces that I cut apart. This is a cut apart from the paper that I fussy cut out. Oh, don't you love this? So when you pop this up, you've got a mat that goes up, a mat that goes down, and a mat that flips out to the side. Let me move this over just a little bit. So you've got a huge amount of space here to put photos. So it flips up, and then this just, let me pull that up. So it just tucks back behind this little flower that's right there. Love it. Now on the next page, I have just a simple pocket that I've made with a flower. And this is one of the cut aparts. And I just stuck that in, make sure I inked that one. And then I have a couple of tags in the top. And see, I left room on these so that the photos could slide underneath. But isn't this just gorgeous, gorgeous paper? Again, this is called Sweet Secrets, and it's by Lemoncraft, and it, excuse me, comes from Poland. Now here is another one that I have done. Now we're at, let's see, four, five, six, seven. This is 8 inch. So this is 8 inches across by, I believe, 7.5 inches high. Now this is the same thing. I've only adhered on the sides. This one has a lot of stuff inside. So here I've just taken my ribbon, which is the same ribbon I've used here and on my tags, and I punched holes in the bottom and tied it together. And then when you open it up, you have a wonderful world of waterfalls. I have a strap here that is just slips in and out. These are, I don't know if they're called journaling cards, I can't remember, but they were just plain like this and plain white on the back. So I decided I was going to turn them each into a waterfall. So I put a pretty ribbon between each one here. And now let's see, what do we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we get 10 pictures here, but then hiding underneath are the square ones, and we can get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 14 photos here. And I think these hold 3x3 square photos. And again, I put some ribbon between each one of these, and then hiding underneath that is another one of these little cut aparts, and inside of it I have a couple of these little bags that my friend Manuela, if you follow my videos, you will have seen that she gifted me a bunch of these she made, and she told me I absolutely could not hoard them. So Manuela, I have a whole bunch of them in this book, and it was really, really hard to part with. So inside, I just have a little booklet here. Isn't this pretty? I just, oh, so pretty. And it slides in and tucks behind. Again, I have left the flowers free in spots so that they make a great holder. And see, this one, I left it free, and then I just used that cloud punch so you get a little hint of the pink behind. And then this one goes in here. What I was going to say is I've left the flowers free in spots so that they will kind of move in and around what you're tucking underneath, and I left this free at the bottom. So we put our waterfall over and down, and then we pull this up, and it's this, I don't think if you weren't tying it would hold it in place, because you can see it gives, but it's really pretty. Now on this one, these were the three sizes that came in that. So I did another waterfall on this side. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, another 12 photos. So look how many photos you have in just this area. And it will expand however much you want because it's tied with a ribbon. So here I have one of those enamel buttons that came in the collection, and I have just tucked my little waterfall underneath it, and that's what holds it. Again, I've used the ribbon to separate them. And I just left it plain on the back. You could put a note in here. What I've seen before is waterfalls being numbered, and then the last page has the numbers and some description about what the photos are. I always thought that was a really neat idea. And these, just simply, you just kind of lift them up and slide them back underneath. So pretty, and so much that you've gotten in just these two pages here. So I hope you'll try that idea if you put your books together like I do. And if you're not sure how to construct a book, in my videos there's a whole series on how do I do that, and it'll show you everything from constructing the book to measuring the hinges, how many hinges and how much paper and how do I space them apart, to adhering them to the book. Those are already there. They're free. Just check out my channel. Okay, this is the same lace that I have here on the front. Is this not gorgeous? But again, I didn't want to put just the lace down because it flip-flops. So I cut a piece of the beige and I adhered the lace to it, except for the middle portion. This part is free. I don't know, let me get a brush here. This part is free so that it will move and give as the book is opened and closed. But this is adhered to this border. And then we have a great area here, and here's spots for four photos here. And I turned this upside down because I just love that ribbon to show. And then here, oh, again, a massive amount of things in this one little thing. I have some fussy cut pieces here. I have one of those elements like this here. I have another of one of Manuela's little envelopes with a tag in it. Again, I want you to see that that's shiny. This is the packaging material again. And I wanted to make sure I put it in so that this pretty flower just kind of hinted through this glassine. And this will hold a great Instagram or iPhone photo. And then I have another one of her bags here with a pull tag out of it. And I have one more of these, so I just tucked it in the top, and these go in like this. And then this lifts up, and you have a huge area for photos, top and bottom and back. Lots and lots of room. And then this just slides right in here, right underneath the lace. There we go, like that. So pretty. Oh, I have it a little crooked. Now I have a button here, another one of those buttons, and this is a huge mat on the end. And then when we turn it this way on the back page, because that's the finish of that now, on the back page of this we have a flap that goes up. This is also a mat that pulls out, and it just goes in the side, and then this one goes in as well, that you can put huge photos on. And it's a little wonkier to get this one in. Oh, I probably should do this. There we go. There we go. I don't want to bend it too much. Until it gets the photos on it and gets a little bit more stability to it, it doesn't know if it wants to slide in that great big pocket. But once you get photos on there and give it even more strength, then you won't have any problem at all. Okay, then we have a huge, huge area here. And then on the back inside cover, I took this beautiful piece of the butterflies. And that's where I've gotten all these butterflies that I've been using throughout the book. I fussy cut them out from these pages. Well, I wanted to have back here just a huge envelope. So I made this giant envelope. But on the outside of it, I put one of my fussy cut flower bouquets, another one of these little tags, some of the butterflies. Now on this one I used, oh, I don't have that here. I had these little metal, they're floppy do things that you put in your flowers. Well, I had one of those sitting here, so I cut it down and I used that for the antenna on that. Beautiful. Now I have a couple more of these wonderful bags that were gifted to me, envelopes. Now this one, I have stuck in a lot more of these for whomever purchases this. They can use these on their pages or as adornment however they see fit. There's another one down there too. And it just slides in. It goes back in the little tiny pocket here. And after you've used everything, then you could put pictures in these. And then in this one, oh, what I put in this one, because you cannot buy this punch anymore, I put in some punches from the paper. And these are, if you wanted to add pulls to anything or pictures, you would have some of these that you can just fold and they would be pulls for your page, your pictures, whatever you want. So we're just going to tuck that in there like that and stick that back behind. And then inside the envelope, again, is all kinds of goodies. Okay, let's see if I have everything out of there. I have a little envelope and I have included some of the pink and some of the seam binding that I've used in case someone wants to add more of it to pictures, tags, or whatever. This one is all full of little tiny butterflies. Oh, there we go. That I have fussy cut out that can be used. This one, I thought I didn't use any of these. I only used the big one, but I thought maybe someone would like to use some. Now, see, this one is glittery. This one's really pretty. Can you see? Oh, there. I don't know if I can get it there where the glitter is. And there's a couple of pinks and a white and some craft tiny little clothespins in this great little bag that was gifted to me. And then I have a couple of mats of different kinds that would be great to put a photo on. This is the template for this front. You just cut it out and then you just adhere it right down and it will fit perfectly. This is the size that you need to cut the photo to go in there. And then this one is the template for the front cover, for the photos that go in the front cover. And then this, I had this laying here and I thought, well, I'll go ahead and make this into a mat and stick it up. Somebody will want to use it. This is free, so you can put your photo underneath. Now, this isn't quite the right size. You probably want to make it larger, but it will show you, I wanted to show you that a photo goes there and it is free, so you can slide underneath. So all of these little goodies are included and they tuck right in this great big envelope back here for whomever decides they can't live without this. There we go. And we've got butterflies, we have clothespins, and we have ribbons and seam binding. And then this just simply tucks behind the butterfly, so it's not sealed. So you can use this after you've used the goodies inside. This will hold memorabilia, tickets, notes, journaling notes, more photos, whatever. And it slides into this ginormous pocket here. I backed the butterflies on a brown, so they are really sturdy. So they'll be fine to hold this. So there's the pages. What do you think? I am totally sold on this type of a mini. So if you're going to make one, determine how wide you want it to be. I wouldn't start any lower than 4 inches and then increase your pages as you want. I increased by an inch because that gave me a really nice visual all the way across as the book is opened, and it still closes perfectly to house everything. So that is my ginormous mini from this collection. Thank you very much, Crafty City, for allowing me to play with these very fun designs from Sweet Secrets Lemon Craft from Poland. I love it. And thank you very much. I will leave my email and some information about this book right below the video if you're interested. I will also leave links to all Crafty City, the store, and Facebook, and other links, plus a Soul's Heartbeat, which is my own personal social media sites. So thank you for joining me, everyone. Have a great crafty day. Make something fun. Bye-bye now.